Ironically, as fast as Sonic is, Detective Pikachu is still beating him to theaters. And from what we're hearing, they have very similar plots. A famous video game character, Pokemon also is very popular in animation, but still, a video game character joins up with a detective to solve a crime, or those kind of activity, and it would be really bad for Sonic if it is indeed the exact same basic setup, because Detective Pikachu, I saw it last week, it's an awful good movie. As I tweeted, it is an intoxicating mix of Roger Rabbit and Blade Runner, and I am 100% serious about that. It's weird, but in a wonderful way. But you know who else is weird in a wonderful way? Mr. Jim Carrey, who is returning to the kind of zany role that put him on the map before he got all awards friendly, which, to be fair, he's very good at as well, but it's just not quite as compelling, certainly at the box office. But let's take a look at Sonic. It also co-stars James Marsden, who does not have such great luck at the box office, and Tika Sumpter, who I really like, actually, and I'm excited to see her kind of level up like this to a bigger property. Or at least we hope it is. Here we go! Oh, that's a cool, I like that sound effect. Gold coins! This is very clever. He does look really weird, though.
You gotta go fast.
The space looks pretty good. That's very cool.
20 minutes ago, an energy surge knocked out power across the entire Pacific Northwest. This needs someone who can figure out exactly what we're dealing with.
You're not suggesting who I think you're suggesting.
We have no choice.
What the?
Are you in charge here?
Yes, I am.
Nope! I'm wrong. I'm in charge.
Allow me to clarify. In a sequentially ranked hierarchy based on level of critical importance, the disparity between us is too vast to quantify. Agent Stone?
The doctor thinks you're basic.
Listen, pal, I don't know if you realize...
I'm sorry, Major. What was your name?
Benny?
Nobody cared! SFPD!
Meow?
Oh, he does not look good, actually. Looks bad.
Oh, come on.
Okay, pal, I want answers. Basically, it looks like I'm gonna have to save your planet.
Ooh! He looks really bad.
No, but thank you for asking.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Whatever this creature is, our job is to secure it, neutralize it, see what makes it tick.
That was great. He did that really well.
Today.
What? That's quick. They're doing a Quicksilver.
Stay in there and be quiet.
How much longer? I can't breathe in here.
Do you have your child in that bag?
No. I mean, yes, it's a child, but it's not mine.
That's
not your child.
It smells like
hilarious.
Bringing an old ham sandwich.
Oh, yes. Ooh. That looks like an end credit scene, maybe. This is the origin of Dr. Robotnik, right? I wish that he was like that for the whole trailer, because I was thinking Jim Carrey's just not zany enough. You know, like, if we want zany Jim Carrey, I want him to go full zany. And I thought he was a little bit muted for the rest of the movie. I hope they didn't do that. I mean, it's like, put it all out on the table, because you might not get a sequel. I think it looks pretty good. I think that Sonic's face just looks really bad. Like, everything else looks... It looks, you know what? It looks kind of Bumblebee-like. And Bumblebee was a very good film. But it wasn't to the level of like a must-see in theaters, as was evidenced by its box office. But I believe it's done quite well on streaming. So I think there's definitely going to be an audience for this. I think people will check it out. But I don't know if it has the cinematic qualities that Detective Pikachu is just overrun with, which is fabulous for that movie. But so I'm, you know, and also you can only have so many of these films before people are like, I've seen enough of them. And so again, that's why speed is also important. I can't believe Tika Sumpter didn't rate a single line in the trailer. That's very unfortunate. But anyway, what did you think? What did you think of Jim Carrey? For if you're a Sonic the Hedgehog fan, what do you think of how they're doing your character for his big screen debut? Write your thoughts down below. Oh, by the way, also, this is from Tim Miller's company. So you would think that they'd have he's Blur Studio, his visual effects company, is involved in this. So you think they'd have a little bit more inventive action sequences. Basically, also, it seems very much like The Roadrunner, but without that kind of humor, which I think is also maybe an odd choice. So anyway, write your thoughts down below. Thank you for watching with me, and you can check out some more videos right now.